Good day, I'm Samantha Allen, and this is your GIS News for August 31. The Jamaican and Chinese governments have signed a $45 million economic agreement for the rehabilitation of Sligoville's road and water systems. Minister with responsibility for sports, Natalie Nita Headley, says the project marks the beginning of a new development process for the first free village in Jamaica, adding that the new water system will meet domestic usage and also supply the multipurpose stadium at Sligoville,
for which we have major plans to become part of the process of having a higher performance center, which will be twinned with the G.C. Foster College to become the northern campus of the G.C. Foster College.
Work on the project is to begin in a month's time and completed within 6 months. It's being undertaken by China Shanks Construction Engineering Corporation. The Organized Crime Investigation Division, OCID, says it has successfully solved a major cybercrime extortion case that involved the online publication of nude photographs of Jamaican females. The criminals reportedly hacked the email accounts of several Jamaican citizens, took control of the accounts, and threatened to publish nude photographs taken from the individual's personal sites if certain sums of monies were not paid. OCID's acting head, acting SSP Clifford Chambers, says that with the support of external partners and the Mobile Reserve, the division has arrested a man believed to be the main player in the cybercrime.
Several digital items, including computers, cell phones, wireless modem, thumb drives, and telephone SIM cards were among the things seized at the location where he was found.
Acting SSP Chambers says forensic examination of the items revealed evidence related to the investigation. The accused has been charged with several offenses under the Cybercrime Act, Obscene Publication, and the Larceny Act. The government and private sector are being urged to join forces and take action in preparation for increased trading as the expansion of the Panama Canal nears completion. President of the Caribbean Shipping Association, Carlos Irio Latam, made the call at a recent awards ceremony of the Shipping Association of Jamaica, the SAJ. The call for integration between the public and private sector was echoed by the Minister of Transport, Works and Housing, Dr. Omar Davies.
But to capitalize on this requires that the labor relations are of such a level of stability that we can proceed knowing that both in construction and in the eventual operation of the new facilities, one can expect the highest level of labor productivity and the greatest predictability in the completion of projects.
Industry, Investment and Commerce Minister Anthony Hilton is encouraging Jamaican entrepreneurs to embrace a broader regional and global business outlook to develop their brands. He was addressing this week's unveiling of baked goods company Honeybun's newest product, branded Goldie, a light and fluffy golden cake filled with cream.
Innovation is indeed the lifeblood of business sustainability. And at this juncture, innovation is the lifeblood of the government's business. Honeybun's strategy is clearly in sync with efforts to strengthen Jamaica's position to take advantage of opportunities in export markets.
The Office of Disaster Preparedness and Emergency Management, ODPEM, has partnered with Intelligent Multimedia Limited, IML, to publicize disaster preparedness tips for the 2012 North Atlantic hurricane season through the medium of digital signage. ODPEM and IML have created two visually stimulating and informative videos that provide tips of what to do before and during a hurricane. As a result of the $3.5 million agreement, the hurricane tips will broadcast at designated locations from August through to December 2012. And finally, Prime Minister Portia Simpson Miller is representing Jamaica at the celebrations marking Trinidad and Tobago's 50th anniversary of independence, August 31. Jamaica and Trinidad and Tobago both celebrate their Golden Jubilee of Independence this month, having been the first two countries in the Caribbean to gain political independence from Britain in 1962. The Trinidad and Tobago Prime Minister was among several dignitaries who participated in Jamaica's independence celebrations on August 6. Mrs. Simpson Miller returns to the island on Sunday, September 2. And that's it for GIS News today. I'm Samantha Allen. Thanks for watching.